Come on, you don't look like you believe me. Who's a wizard? Well, then I'm not doing any magic tricks, because you can probably do better things than I could do as a wizard. You do? You have a magic set? That's cool. You do science at your house? That's nice, too. All right, but you haven't seen my trick yet, have you? Hold on, sit right there. See if this works. Okay, so you're supposed to turn around when a magician is performing. You might see something you're not supposed to see. So the reading this morning, could you hold that for me, please? Reading this morning was about Jesus being at a wedding, and the guests, they have no more wine to drink, which is not a good thing. So Jesus takes water and he turns it into wine. Okay, so what is this? That's water, right? Thank you. Right? Just plain water? Okay, hold on. I'm going to do some magic. You stay right where you are. It's not even pink, lemon, purple grape juice. Abracadabra, zim, zam, zoom. What do we have now? Oh, hold on. Oh, sorry. Look! Taste it. See what it tastes like. Oh, hide that. Tastes like watery wine, right? Here, you taste it. You're not sick, right? Are you sick? You have cold, or don't taste it, because I don't want to. Look, isn't that cool, though? I magically turned this water into whatever it is now. That's right, thank you. I turned this water into apple juice. Doesn't taste like anything? No. So you think that's what Jesus did? You think Jesus did the same kind of miracle? Tastes sour? It's really okay. It was just a little, I have to tell you my trick now. I put a little grape juice in it. So that's how Jesus did miracles too, right? When nobody was looking, he turned his back and he went.
No.
No? What do you do? I know. He goes like this. He says, bring me that water. So they bring him some water and he says, now take it to the chief steward of the festival. That would be Ryan, right? He's the boss. Because he says, you can't serve this. This tastes sour. So Jesus took it to, they took it to Ryan, and Ryan actually said at that wedding, he said, oh my gosh, this is really good wine. Where'd you get this wine? That's what he said. Do you remember saying that way back 2,000 years ago? No, you weren't. But if you were the steward and you were there, that would have been your job. And you would have gone, oh my gosh, this water, this is wonderful wine, because he didn't know it used to be water. So Jesus did a miracle, right? He changed ordinary water into wine. Yeah, right. Yeah, boogaloo, boogaloo. I don't know if you said that. But isn't that miracles? What? So what else do you want to talk about today? Chocolate milk. Now, that would be cool. If I could turn water to chocolate milk, that would be awesome, wouldn't it? But the reason Jesus did a miracle was to prove that he had a lot of power, that he could do anything. Do you believe that? Yes, Jesus could turn flowers into a crocodile if he wanted to. Or, how about this? He could turn crocodiles into flowers. That would be even better. That's right. That would be even more interesting. So Luke, with your magic kit, right? Do you really like work miracles, or is it just a trick? A trick, but nobody knows the trick, so they're like, wow, that's cool. But Jesus didn't just do tricks, he did miracles. He changed things. Just like this miracle. How about this miracle? Right here, some of you right here were changed a little bit in the baptismal water again, from who you are to a child of God. It's heavy. You want me to take it off? rocks and a branch.
And nothing else.
And water. So in the water, Jesus turned you. What's the matter? Into a child of God. Look, what could be worse than drinking sour water or grape juice thing? So that's a miracle. You know what the other miracle is? You're going to live forever with God. How's that for a miracle? Unless you're in hell. Then why did you guys come up this morning anyway? Despite the pastor, someone